Johnny Manziel will be top three on an NFL team's quarterback depth chart come August. So a backup's backup. Mm. Will he be on a depth chart in the NFL?
Training camp.
I'm gonna say no. I mean, here's the thing. I would love for Johnny Manziel to go to Canada. Go to Canada and prove it. Play ball. Have all your coaches sing about how good you are and how committed you are, and then join. Because, Kate, the fact is, we don't even know if Johnny Manziel is good enough to play football. And before you even get to the part of his personal conduct and the acting like a professional, the football we saw from him was not great. Now, I know, Nate, you were in training camp. He's got potential. When he got on the field, it wasn't great. So he's very famous. He has a big following. I'm all rooting for him. I'd love to see him go to Canada, kill it, and then come back down here.
You're a little negative Nelly on this segment.
I figure me as an honest Abe, truly. I'm not going to BS you,
Kate. He's going to say top three on all these things. It's hard to say no, and I'm going to say no on this one. And I think what he said himself after the pro day was, I'd love to be in the NFL, but if not, I'll go to Canada. I think that was a big sigh of relief for everybody.
Huge.
Because it shows that I actually want to play football. Like, it's not about the fame. It's not about the celebrity. It's not about the NFL jersey endorsement. I want to play football. And so I'm going to think the best thing for Johnny Manziel, and his agent might be upset or the people around him might be upset saying this, is go and do a little thing in Canada, prove that you could do it and do it on a team level, and then come back. And yes, next August. Come on.
Listen.
When he said that, I thought of you. I was like, oh, that makes
perfect.
Sense.
Perfect. My heart, my gut, the wide receiver in me, the guy that caught passes from him that summer when I played in Cleveland says, yes, hell yes, he's going to be on a team. He'll be top three. He'll compete for a number two spot. But understanding the game, being removed now, and seeing this from a bird's eye view, it's not. If my memory serves me correctly, I believe I read an article about Brandon Weeden being signed recently to the Houston Texans, right? And he hasn't played since 2015, which means in this game, whether you're Johnny Manziel, been out for whatever reason, whether you're Colin Kaepernick, out for whatever reason, this game is very unforgiving. And it's not unforgiving for what you have done necessarily, but more unforgiving because there's other players, whether they're vets that's been sitting at home or young rookies that are trying to get a chance in this league. There's so many guys that want that spot, that prime real estate, which is the quarterback room, and there's guys that are willing to do it and work for cheap. So I'm going to say not for that reason.
Do you think the decision for a team to bring in Johnny Manziel at this point when he has been so removed and he really just wants to play is still sort of like a risk or like a distraction to bring him into training camp?
Yeah.
Is that going to be considered?
For a day.
Does he still like garner that?
You saw we showed footage of the Texas A&M Pro Day. We broke into Good Morning Football to show it.
But once training camp starts and all that, it'll still be like Johnny Manziel.
It'll be a number one story. We'll be talking about it.
Because that's going to play into whether or not teams even want to bring him in as the number three. What's the point? Why would I want to deal with that?
I want Drew Stanton as my backup. I want Chad Henne. I want those guys who are lifers, who know how to step in. I mean, the idea, I know Jerry Jones has always fancied Johnny Manziel. Him going to Dallas, I think would be a disaster, truly, for him to sit there behind Dak. Dak did not have the greatest season last year. So that's what I'm talking about. I think that's a mushroom cloud.